One in three of us will develop cancer in our lifetime, and this means that each and every one of us will be touched by cancer in some way. Here's one family story.
I feel angry at the cancer for destroying everything. Every dream, hope. I feel like I've gone from building a life to having nothing and to readjust it.
Everything stops. Totally everything stops. You want to jump off the world, but you can't because you want to be there for her.
I was diagnosed with cancer in August of 2013, and I was 32. My cancer, endometrial cancer, I'd never even heard of. I'd heard of ovarian and cervical and breast cancer, but endometrial, it was kind of like, what is that? I never would assume that just having to take a womb away would be the only hope of being cancer-free. I had to have external pelvic radiotherapy, and then I had to have something called brachytherapy, which is internal radiotherapy. They basically put a radioactive rod inside the vagina, and you're basically sat in a room. You're not allowed to move, and I had to have it for 19 hours at one go. It was really hard. Radiotherapy is a very intense burning pain. You just feel like your whole vagina's on fire. But only that, it's like when you go to the loo as well, just like really burning sensation.
Your heart is sink so far at times when you see her in pain that you wish you could take that pain and take the pain instead and give some of your life back to her.
We're doing some cooking with Auntie Clare.
All her friends are married and have children. She would have been perfect. What a mum she would have made.
I can't have children. I can't physically have children. I think that's the hardest part of it, I think, really. Just... sorry. I always wanted to be a mum out of everything in life. And I know some people can say to you, well, you left it too long, or you should have settled down in your 20s and stuff, but you don't think about that. But I won't deny there are times where I think, why can't that be me? Like, why can't I have that family? What did I do to deserve it?
Devastation. Trauma. Plenty of tears. And then you put a brave face on to say, yeah, it'll be all right. And then you go away and cry.
They discovered that in my husband's family, nearly all the women who died have died from breast cancer. The youngest, I think, was 45. And then there was a couple of incidents of bowel cancer on my side of the family. So Claire's been offered genetic testing.
If I'm found positive for the gene, it means I'm at higher risk and higher probability of getting the bowel and breast cancer. And then I'd have to face all that journey as well.
I've done quite a few, actually.
This is your bucket list.
I think my biggest fear is having to say goodbye when you're not ready to go yet.
Japan, Hong Kong, China. We've got one whole Asian trip there.
Yeah. I'm not ready to say goodbye. I'm ready to keep fighting. But I guess I'm scared the fight's a bit bigger than me.
All this week, Channel 4's standing up to cancer, and we want you to get involved. Your money can and will make a difference. To donate by phone, call 0300 123 4444 and remember to have your credit or debit card to hand. To donate online, go to channel4.com/SU2C. Or if you want to send a text, you can donate £5 or £10 by texting the word 5 or 10 to 70404. 100% of your donation will go to the Stand Up to Cancer campaign. Join me, Alan Carr, Dr. Christian and a whole host of stars for a very special evening of entertainment live on Friday night on 4.